Looking at a high-level view of the grid, whatever technology is being put on the grid, it needs to be reliable, flexible, and also cost-effective. ARPA-E feels it's important to focus on the grid in three key areas: software, hardware, and also energy storage.
In order to transition to an advanced grid, the grid needs to be able to modify the capacity to allow the system to reconfigure and adapt to different system conditions.
You're faced really with transmitting power over long distances by alternating current, and that usually requires some amount of active power control and a lot of power conversion.
The grid was designed for one-way transmission and for fossil fuel combustion that simply ramped up and ramped down to meet demand. The biggest obstacle to us getting a large fraction of our electricity from wind and sunshine is their intermittency. So if we could mass produce a battery that safely and cost effectively stores massive amounts of electrical energy, we could solve this problem.
Where we're focused on the transmission side is looking at developing new switching technologies, not only in the solid state, but also in the gas tube. Increasing reliability in the gas tube is key because a gas tube has some of the highest performance values as far as breakdown voltage and current.
A lot of people have described this project as back to the future. In the last 50 years or so, solid state came in, but tubes, it didn't stop advancing either. The gas tubes that we're developing here individually should be able to handle much higher voltages and much higher current ratings than current solid-state switches. And instead of having thousands of these switches in a building, maybe you're going to have a few to do the power conversion. This really is tailor-made for our main objective on the program, which is high-power, long-distance power transmission.
Our energy storage efforts has led to a renaissance in battery chemistry.
There are two important measures of the capacity of a battery. One is the amount of energy it can store, and the other is the rate at which it can deliver that energy out of storage. We noticed a class of chemicals called quinones that are in chlorophyll, where they undergo oxidation and reduction over and over and over again without any sign of degradation. And that's exactly the functionality you want in a battery. We found a way to bring their solubility in water up to high levels. We put them in a flow battery and the performance is terrific. It rivals the performance of vanadium after less than a year. The ability to store more and more energy in large tanks full of chemicals is a way to size up the energy capacity of your storage much more cheaply than stacking up banks of batteries. The chemicals we've developed for flow batteries are a fraction of the cost of vanadium. ARPA-E has allowed us to try out a brand new idea and make it work in a very short amount of time. It's very exciting.
Software control for the grid ties all of these technologies together.
TCA is a precision tool that focuses on reducing congestion and reducing the cost of generation in the grid. Our software identifies which reconfigurations are reliable and provide economic benefits, as well as increase the penetration of renewable power, including being able to extract more value out of facilities that have been in place for a long time. Our next steps in the topology control algorithms project are to tie them with the very physical realities of the power grid, making sure that each configuration identified is a fully reliable and implementable reconfiguration that brings the benefits that we have estimated.
The difference between what we do today and what TCA can help us do tomorrow is enormous.
Without ARPA-E funding, we would not have been able to achieve the progress we could make on topology control algorithms.
ARPA-E is a partner that can help us share the cost of this very risky development. We want to really change the game on the cost of these high-power AC-DC conversion stations.
Our battery looks very competitive for long-term energy storage.
The impact of our programs focused on the grid will lead to a cost-effective, economically and friendly delivery of energy where you need it and when you need it.